chosen a better way to spend your evening. So thank you so much for being here. We're very excited that our Lamar Louise Curry concert series is back up and running after a couple of years where we had to take a little bit of a hiatus, as most things did. But we're just so grateful for your support, for the support of our wonderful pastor, Reverend Hetty Culver, and the music staff here at the church. So welcome, and we know you're going to enjoy the evening. Just a couple of logistical things. There are restrooms out in the narthex. Ladies to the right, gentlemen to the left. We will be taking a 15-minute intermission, so please feel free to stand up. You'll know when to get up when the lights come on, and you'll know when to come back when the lights go out. So please come back before the lights go out. And then we will be having a brief reception afterwards out in the narthex. We have some cookies and coffee for you. So please do stay and feel free to, I believe you'll be able to meet our wonderful artist. So we again want to welcome you. Thank you so much for being here. I'd also like to introduce Seth Carlson, who is our concert series director. He's the organist here at First United Methodist, and he's going to introduce Chelsea, our artist of the evening.
Well, good evening, everyone. Thank you for coming out tonight. This is going to be such a special concert. Let me just tell you, first of all, the instrument we have here at First United Methodist is such a special pipe organ here in Miami. It's the second largest, and it is just a very versatile instrument, and you're going to hear that tonight, the way Chelsea plays, bringing out all the different colors and using all the different stops. It's just going to be magical. I met Chelsea back in 2015. I had just moved to Miami, and I heard that Chelsea Chen, the famous concert organist, was the organist and artist in residence up in Fort Lauderdale at Coral Ridge Presbyterian Church. So I was a student at the University of Miami, and I drove up there on a Sunday morning, and I sat there and I heard Chelsea play. And then I had enough guts to go up to her afterwards and say, hello, you know, I'm a super fan. And anyway, from there, we became great friends. And tonight, it's awesome that we get to collaborate together for the Rheinberger Organ Concerto. You'll get to hear that in the second half. And anyway, I don't want to keep talking because I know you want to hear the organ. So without further ado, would you please help me welcome Chelsea Chen.
Thank you. Good evening, everyone. It's so wonderful to be back here in Miami. This concert, we tried to schedule for the last 3 years, but fortunately, it's finally happening, and I'm so glad because the choir and the orchestra get to be involved in the second half, and that is so unusual and so fun for me, because normally I'm all by myself, as you see, and you're gonna hear lots of different things out of the organ. You just heard what an epic operatic march, and now we're going to go to another transcription for the organ. This is from the little piano pieces by Debussy, Girl with the Flaxen Hair, followed by Arabesque number 2. And these are very wonderful for the organ because you can, it showcases the flutes and the strings, the softer colors on the organ, the more unusual sounds that you might not associate with the organ.
Thank you.
The next piece is the second suite that I ever wrote based on Taiwanese folk songs. And this particular piece I wrote while I had the opportunity to live in Taiwan. I lived there right after college between degrees, and it was an amazing year because I had grown up speaking some Mandarin with my grandmother, who didn't speak English when she was living in our house in California. But there was a gap of between my ages of 8 and at this point I was 22, where I didn't speak much Chinese at all. So this was full immersion back into this culture. And it was fascinating to me because some of these melodies, I vaguely recalled hearing my grandmother sing when I was very young. And then I was hearing them arranged for every type of instrument possible, from street musicians to concert artists, and even this music gets played on the airplane when you're going to Taiwan. It's arranged every old way, but not for the organ. And so it was a big project for me to collect these songs that I liked and arrange them in a way that would make sense for the organ. So this suite starts with a movement called Four Seasons, and it's nothing to do with Vivaldi. It's really just a brief song about two young lovers who go through, they chase each other around, and they go through seasons together. That's what it's about. The second one is called The Cradle Song. It's a lullaby. And then the third one is a bit of a jaunty song called Song of the Country Farmer. And this was actually not such a happy song at the time, because Taiwan, when this song was written, it was the 1930s, very poor, very difficult chapter. But the song was meant to uplift people's spirits.
Thank you.
We're going to close the first half with one of the great works of organ literature. This is the Prelude and Fugue on Alain by Durufle. And Durufle was a very famous organist in France, and he didn't leave behind a lot of organ music, but all of his pieces, maybe an hour and a half worth of music for solo organ, are amazing pieces. But this particular one means a lot because he wrote it for his dear friend, the composer Jean Alain, whose name is in this piece. And his friend Jean Alain was also a talented organist and composer who might have gone on to become as famous as Durufle, but unfortunately he died very young in his 20s fighting in the French army during World War II. And so to honor his friend, he took the most famous piece that Alain had written to that point. It was called Litanies, and he quotes the famous melody, dun 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 dun, and this whole melody appears at the end of the prelude, but also snippets of it, fragments of it, almost like a dream of it, comes in the middle of this prelude, so you will hear that. But you will also hear the letters of Alain's name converted into notes, and it just so happens that L and I and N are not usually in the musical scale, which just goes to A to G, and so you have to start the letters over. And H is a special case, so we leave it aside, it's a B, but I becomes A, J becomes B, K becomes C. That's how he was able to convert it to musical notes, and it worked out great because the letters are the notes are A, D, and F, and A. So those are all notes which fit into D minor. And so you'll hear that in both the prelude and in the fugue. So to say something about the fugue, it starts off serenely and a little bit slowly, but it builds up into a double fugue, and it's brilliant. It's almost like a resurrection at the end.